Write the function f of x equals 2x squared minus x minus 6 in factored form. So notice there's a coefficient of 2 for the x squared. That means I'm going to use factor by grouping. So I'm going to multiply the 2 and the negative 6. That makes negative 12. And I need to find the factors of negative 12 that add to this negative 1, which is the coefficient for the x term in the middle. Okay, so let's see, 6 and 2, one of them has to be negative. Negative 6 plus 2 is negative 4, and if I switch the signs, it would be positive 4, so that won't work. How about 4 and 3? Negative 4 plus 3. Negative 1. Okay, so there's our pair of numbers right here. So negative 4 plus 3 is negative 1. And negative 4 times 3 makes negative 12. So here's the factor by grouping. F of x equals 2x squared minus 4x plus 3x minus 6. And that first step, all I did is split up the middle term of negative 1x into the two factors that we need. So for this first term, I can see there's a 2x in common, so I'll factor that out. And then that'll leave an x for the first part, and then a negative 2 for the second part. Because 2x times x makes 2x squared, and 2x times negative 2 makes negative 4x. Now for the next two terms, I can see there's a positive 3 in common, so I'll take that out, and that leaves an x minus 2. The next part is the grouping. So we're going to have this 2x and then plus the 3 from right here. That's going to be our first binomial factor, and then the x minus 2 is going to be the second binomial factor. Okay, so what's the advantage of doing this? Well, now this function's in factored form. I could easily find the zeros if I wanted to. I could also plot these zeros and try to graph it that way, find the vertex. So basically, when you write in this factored form, you're highlighting what the zeros are. And then you could use the zero product property to quickly determine what they are if you needed to.